Hi there, homespun friends. It is Sherry, and it's wonderful to see you on this Monday afternoon. I'm getting ready to begin cooking dinner, but I have been doing some grocery shopping this afternoon, and I wanted to show you my haul. Now, I started out at the Mighty Dollar looking for a few more Bible journaling supplies, and I was very blessed to find them, as well as a lot of Valentine's baking-related materials, like little cupcake holders and some neat items that my husband could use with all of the baking he's doing. He has been making pies like crazy. He has been making chocolate meringue and lemon meringue, and he's been making cakes, and he's just really been going nuts with all of his baking, and he's been practicing up to get ready to make all the desserts for our church's Valentine's dinner or banquet. We're having it for all the couples in our church that want to sign up and come, and it's going to be like a steak dinner, and he's thinking about making all those desserts for this party. So we'll see how that turns out, but I want to tell you, those of you who are my Facebook friends and you've been seeing my husband's cakes and pies, you can tell that he knows what he's doing. He is a wonderful baker, and he really gets into it. He's intense about it. He wants it to be perfect. So he's been practicing a lot of different types of things that are his specialties leading up to something even bigger that he wants to do. I'll let you know how that goes. But I bought him a few things at Mighty Dollar that I thought he would have fun practicing with, that are all Valentine related. But I want to show you that in a future video. For now, I'm going to turn this camera around and I'm going to show you my grocery haul. This consists of Lidl, Aldi, and Food Lion. I was not wanting to go to Food Lion today, but because neither Lidl or Aldi had any slaw mix, I decided to go ahead and go to Food Lion. They also did not have any premium sweet onions. They usually do. And so, but Food Lion always has those things. So I made a Food Lion trip. Food Lion is like just not even hardly a mile from my house. It's very close. And the other stores are within 2 miles, very close also. So I didn't have to go far to get these deals. And that's why I'm willing to make multiple stops. Now, I started at Lidl where I got, this was one of those superpower buys of the week. As you can see, these are large paper towels where two of these rolls really is like four regular rolls. This was $1.31 for these two paper towels, and so I bought 5 sets. And one of the reasons I buy so many paper products like this, and you'll see them in my videos often, especially when I go to Sam's, is because this is one of the things I tend to share with my children and their families. Let's see, what day was it? Saturday night. It's Monday. So Saturday night, my daughter called and she said, "Mom, it's date night at church. We have the kids at the little daycare there and we've been out to eat. And we thought before we run back and pick up the kids, we'd swing by your house and see if you have any paper towels, dishwashing soap, and trash bags." And I said, I will fix that up for you and have it ready so you can just walk in the door and grab it and go. And they don't always call me, but a lot of times they'll call me if they're in a hurry somewhere. And they're just not going to have time to get out or drag all of the children out with them. And this is one of the ways I can bless my family because I'm always trying to look for deals. So I think this is an amazing deal. $1.31 for these 2 large rolls of paper towels. And I also purchased these 3 packages of tissues for $2.49. I'm trying to remember what else I got at Lidl, but as I go, I'll tell you where I got each thing. This was a deal I got at Food Lion. These diapers were reduced to $6.99, and then I got an extra $2 off. So they were only $4.99. And both of my daughters have children that are still in diapers, and do they all wear 4s now? Yes. All 3 of the children that are in diapers wear a size 4, and so that helps. So that's why I've been getting 4s. I used to get 4s and 6s, but I think the one grandchild that was wearing the 6s is now fully potty trained, even at night. So the 4s is what I get. And I picked up these at Lidl, the goldfish. I think they were $1.89. A couple of cans of the green and white lima beans. I love lima beans. It's one of my favorites. These shrimp are so good. I got these at Lidl. As you can see, they are peeled and deveined, and the tail is already off. And what I do with these, and it's my daughter and son-in-law that taught me what they do with them, they just try to put them in overnight in the refrigerator if you can, but if not, you can put them in the sink with cold water, and it won't take them very long to kind of thaw a little bit. And then you just put some olive oil and in a pan with a little bit of butter and garlic salt. I actually bought this time some Old Bay seasoning. I was out. I had run out since last time. But you saute this up, and then you take you can take your noodles and also butter them and put garlic in them and put the shrimp and noodles together, and it is really good. And I have even thought about trying shrimp and grits, which is one of my husband's favorites when we go to a restaurant. He enjoys them. But these bags are just $4.99 for these shrimp, and I picked up two. The low-fat chocolate milk was 60 cents today, so I picked up that. Here's the item that sent me running to Food Lion. I love this coleslaw, and I just throw mayonnaise with it. Or I saw a recipe this week that I think I'm going to try, and I purchased some sausage to go with this. What you do is you saute your sausage in a frying pan. You add some ginger and garlic to it. Then you put your coleslaw mix in there, your cabbage, and some soy sauce, and you mix it all together, and it makes a wonderful, like a Japanese-type dinner, and it looks so good. The exact directions are on Facebook. I'll have to tell you how that turns out, and if I like it, I'll give you better directions on it. If any of you have tried any kind of thing like that, let me know. It looks super easy to make and very delicious. I bought some spaghetti. Now, you know, we were doing low carb, and we're still trying to watch some of our carbs, but they had no zucchini or squash today, so I'm just having to take what I can get. I also got a little bit of bread. Our last batch of bread, about a fourth of it went bad because we don't eat it that often, but only now and then. But we like to have it. And I'll tell you, the bread that we really like is this bread, this rye bread, and the pumpernickel. And it actually has less carbs than most breads. And this is the kind that's the swirl. And I think that would be a really good with what we're doing. We're usually eating just ham and turkey sandwiches. I got some broccoli coleslaw. These were buy one, get one free chips. The chili cheese and the cheddar jalapeno is my daughter Natalie's favorite when she's here. Steak sauce I picked up. And these two boxes of corn dogs, I normally would not get two boxes, but they were 2 for $6. And if you bought two of them, you got an additional dollar off. These are great when the grandkids come. They really do enjoy them. So I got two boxes of that. I got a bag of sweet potatoes, which is my grandson Brody's favorite thing to eat. He's very, 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 very picky about food. But he loves sweet potatoes. So that's for him. I got some of these mashed potatoes. These, I guess, the dried kind. The reason is because I'm thinking about starting back with a sourdough mix. I'm thinking about creating a sourdough starter, and the potato flakes is one of the things that is cauliflower in the starter that I use. And so I thought I would put this back. It lasts a long time. When I get ready, I'm going to try that again. And then I got some French onion dip. Here's some pie crust. Now, my husband can make wonderful pie crust on his own, but it's just one more step in the whole process of what he's trying to do when he makes these pies. So he loves these pie crusts from Aldi. They're only $1.39, and there's two in here. And so when he makes his, you know, he bakes his own everything and puts it in these crusts. So I try to pick them up for him because it just takes one step out when you find out, let's say this, like today. Yesterday we had a death in our church, and so he made a lemon meringue pie just instantly. He was already tired and worn out from working all day yesterday, and so having this pie crust already prepared just made it faster. $1.39. So if you've never tried these and you like to bake, that's something good that you can do. The eggs today, a lot of people are curious about the prices of eggs and milk. Our milk right now is just over $1, and the eggs were 79 cents. These smoked turkey ballpark white meat franks, I love them. They freeze very, very well. So when they had them 2 for $6, I'll put them in the freezer. And this spring and summer, when we're starting to break out into the cookouts, these will come out. They're some of my favorite, and they're very low points if you do Weight Watchers. These were at Lidl. Lidl has a lot of really unique things. These were from Christmas. They're the whole cloves that, you know, you can put in your orange, and you know they smell amazing. And they had these for just 99 cents. And they last until, let's see, August the 30th of 2022. So I feel sure we'll use them by then. And then a bag of chicken breast. I've been using my Instant Pot with these, and I'm just going to tell you, I absolutely love it. So I'm hoping to do a video soon on how I've been, the different ways I've been preparing the chicken breast in the Instant Pot. If you don't have an Instant Pot, I'm just going to tell you, I think if you do some cooking, you're going to love it, and it's not as intimidating as you think. I picked up a couple cans of this solid white tuna. Now, here's my sausage that I told you would go with one of my coleslaw mixes that I was going to try this week, so I bought the sausage. I bought a couple cans of green beans. We are supposed to have a snow day. It's supposed to start snowing tomorrow evening and snow all night into the next morning. We're not going to get a lot of snow, just an inch or so, maybe a two, what they're saying right now. But one of the things I've always made when we have snow days is cinnamon rolls. And we haven't had them in a long time because we haven't had a snow day in a while. And the last time, it seems like the last time we had a little snow, I didn't even have them in the house. So I thought I would go ahead and put that back for that special time. And then I've got this four cheese sauce, spaghetti sauce. This is from Aldi, and this is also from Aldi. I like to keep this on hand for my meatloafs. And then I've got some apples here. The Honeycrisp apples were only $1.29 today for a pound, which is fantastic, as you know. And so I bought five of those. I also picked up some more of our low-carb bars because we do every bit that we can try to watch it. And then there is the chicken stock that I like to use when I'm making my chicken breast. I bought a couple of these wide egg noodles. We use them in a lot of different little recipes. You know, these will probably last a little while for us. I picked up some broccoli. Steamed broccoli is one of our favorites. Of course, lemon for all those lemon meringue pies. And of course, there's the onions I told you that Lidl and Aldi did not have. These things were $4.99, so I really splurged to get them, but it's really not the season for sweet onions. As you know, they're going to cost more because it's sort of out of season, and but it's just one of the things that I really feel like I need to have because straight onions tend to upset my stomach. So I just try to stick with the sweet ones and pay a little bit more, but because it's just the two of us, these will last me a good little while. I mean, I cook for my family when they come, but if I made hot dogs, I'd cut up a couple onions or something, but overall, I mean, these will last a good little while. Now, I bought some cake mixes, and so you may be thinking, if you have a baker in the family, why are you buying cake mixes that are pre-made like this? Well, one of the reasons is because my husband is going to be making a cake for our grandson for his fifth birthday, which is in a couple weeks. And he has asked for a white cake. He loves white cake. He just loves it in the box. He loves the white cake in the box. And so my husband is going to make him that, and he's also going to top it with a special frosting that is homemade. And he is, we've bought the kit, and I'll show you that kit before you go, of Sonic the Hedgehog. And it's very hard to find Sonic the Hedgehog. It's really coming, it's a classic type, I guess, figure, but it's coming back in style now. So if you have little grandsons, maybe you've heard of Sonic the Hedgehog, but he plays the video games. And any books or anything he can get his hands on with Sonic, he loves it. And so Papa's getting ready to make a cake out of a couple of these. And then as he's practicing making cupcakes, he is just going to use a couple of box mixes. I've got both chocolate and white for him to try. He was thinking about making a large tiered cake with columns for our Valentine banquet and having some cupcakes all around it that would be easier for the people to eat. And I just bought him a set of 50 Russian tips where you can make the flowers that actually stand up on the top of the cupcakes. Maybe you've seen those beautifully decorated cupcakes. Well, I bought him the tips. They just came in, and he's wanting to practice. And he just said, give me a couple cake mixes because it would be just so much easier for me to use a cake mix, make the cupcakes, and practice on those rather than spending the time to make a homemade cake and, you know, and practice on that. So I bought these for him. We try to keep some of those up in the cabinet. Have any of you heard of the cookies that you can make using cake mix? Like, you would take this devil's food cake and you could make like the chocolate, what do they call it, crinkle cookies, and roll them in, you know, the powdered sugar and all, out of cake mix. I had seen that on Facebook also, and I thought that would be neat to try. So I don't know, maybe we'll try that one of these days. And then of course I bought us just some drinks to have around the house. So there you go, friends. That is my big purchase. Let me see if I can remind myself what I paid for everything. I think I paid $29 at Lidl. I paid $45 at Aldi and I think I paid about that much at Food Lion, and this is a haul that will last us for a while. Now, we went to the meat market that's right down the street from our house on Saturday, and we bought two steaks for about $9, and they were out of this world. That was our dinner date for Saturday night. And then my husband bought me several pounds of hamburger meat down there, and it was only $7.78 for maybe like, oh my goodness, I don't know if it was 3 or 4 pounds. I mean, I got a lot. That's what I'm trying to say. I got a lot for my money. So anyway, I've got that in the fridge, and I'll be using that to make me some spaghetti. And I think that tomorrow when it snows, I'm going to make homemade soup. Doesn't that sound good? Does everybody like just throw stuff in the pot and make homemade soup when it snows? I think they do, because it seems like I see a lot of that. Now, let me just show you the little piping tips that my husband got. As you can see, this is kind of what the kit looks like. This is from United Cake. Okay, let me see if I can get this off. Okay, and that's what these little tips look like. They have these little amazing different kinds of tips on them, and they make roses, and they just make all kinds of beautiful designs. If you have never seen the Russian piping tools, you need to go onto YouTube and pull that up and watch people decorate with these tips. It's amazing. We've been watching a lot of it as he's been preparing to try it out. So there are the tips. And then I'm going to show you from Amazon the little cake supplies that I bought for my grandson's cake for his birthday. And I know we're going to pass out when I tell you this. Sit down, because I don't want you to fall. But I paid $25 for this kit. You'll do anything, and I mean just about anything, for your grandchild. But this was the only thing that he really asked for. He didn't even care about toys. He just said, please, I want a Sonic Hedgehog cake. And as we went around, nobody really could make one as well as we could just buy this and have Papa make it. And these are the little figures down here that he can keep. They're hard plastic. And the goal of the game is Sonic runs down these paths that have fences and obstacles and jumps over cliffs and things like that. And as he's running, he's trying to hit all of these little gold circles. They're like little tubes, and he's trying to hit them, and they look like this. The little rings, I guess, is what they're called. And the more rings that he, you know, hits as he's running, then the more points that he gets. And here are the little jewels that go with the game. You can collect these also. So anyway, here is the little kit that Papa will be using to create that wonderful birthday cake for our grandson. And I know that he's going to be pretty excited about that. If I can remember, I'll try to do a quick video and show you the cake when it's finished. It's going to be fairly simple in its premise, but you know, it doesn't take a lot to impress a five-year-old. They're pretty easy to impress. So that's what we're hoping anyway. Well, friends, there you go. There's my haul. Thank you so much for spending time with me. And as you know, I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye-bye.